Hello everyone, my name is Ranjit. I welcome you on the Tuition Rocks channel. This is the online and offline platform for clearing all your doubts and the concepts. So today I am going to continue with the problems based on the arithmetic progressions. So if you are viewing us for the first time, I would request you to go back in the playlist and search for the arithmetic progressions where I have discussed the concepts regarding that. So whatever the concept we have learnt in the arithmetic progression, that we will be applying in solving the problems. So let's get started. So I have written down the two questions here. How many 3-digit numbers are divisible by 87? And in AP, if the mth term is n and the nth term is m, show that the rth term is m plus n minus r. So let's see how to solve these problems, how to go about these problems. Now, first question, let's do one by one. How many 3-digit numbers are divisible by 87? So we need to find the numbers which are divisible by 87, and that should be 3-digit number. So minimum 3-digit number is 100, we know that. And the maximum 3-digit number is 999. So between these only, the multiples of the 87 should be present now. So how do you do that? So what is the, least 3-digit number which will be divisible by 87? How to find it? Just divide the 87, divide by 87 and put it in the mixed fraction. Let's try to do that. This also will put it in the mixed fraction. So how much you got? 87 ones are. So 100 minus 7 is? 100 minus 87 is 3 and this becomes 13. 13 by 87. So we got a mixed fraction is 113 by 87. Second is, again we'll divide it here if you're not comfortable. Let's divide it here. 999 by 87. So 187. So 9 minus 7, 2. 129. Got it? 129 now. Again, it will go with the 1 only. So, 87. So, what happened? 9 minus 7 is 2. 8 plus minus 8 is 4. So, 42. So, we got this mixed fraction is 11. 42 by 87. Okay? Now, look at this. So, more than 1 will be, when you have a quotient more than 1, that is 2. 2 into 87 will be the least number which is divisible by 87. So, let's put it here. 87 into 2 is the least number. This is the lower limit and this is the maximum limit. Now maximum limit is 11 because 11 into 87 that will be lesser than the 999. So we got it here, 87 into 11. Got it now? Simple, right? Now we the first term we get it here is 2 sevens of 14 carry 1, 2 is 16 plus 7, 174. Now here what we get now, 11 sevens are 77, 11 eights are 88, 88 plus 7 is nothing but 59. So we get is 957, so we get 9 good. So first term, look at this, what we got, first term we got is a is equal to this one and then nth term is 957. Now we have learnt the, for finding the nth term, with the general expression is nothing but a of n is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay? So because every time the common difference will be 87, because 87 multiple, right? 87 1's are 87, 87 2's are 174, like this will go. So 87, so common difference becomes the 87. D is equal to, we have is 87. D is equal to 87. Now let's try to substitute the values and get the answer for the n. So this becomes a 957 is equal to 174 plus n minus 1 into 87. Correct? Now let's try to transpose 174 to this side. So it becomes 7 minus 4 is 3. Now y minus 750 minus 7 is 8. 8 minus 1 is 7. 783 is equal to n minus 1 into 87. Correct? Now we'll again transpose n minus 1 is equal to 783 by 87, correct? So 87, when you just do this one, so 87 9's are 9 7 63 6 9 8 72 6 7 8 7. So n is equal to 1 plus 9 is equal to 10. So basically you got is 10 total numbers between the total numbers which are between the 100 and 999 which is divisible by 87 is nothing but 10 numbers. You got it? So this is how we have to approach it. So we applied the general formula for finding the nth term and we could get the total number of digits which are total number of 3 digits which are possible between the 100 and 999 which is divisible by 87. Okay. Now let's go to the second question. Now, similarly, we'll apply the same formula in solving the other part of the question. Now, let's do that. So, this question says that mth term is, so nothing to get confused about it. It's just the general form of representation. Okay. So what we have learnt is nth term. A of n is nothing but the first term plus n minus 1 into common difference. Correct? Now he says that mth term is n. So let's try to understand mth term. So mth term can be represented as the a of n is nothing but first term, let's assume, is a only plus n. So this will be mth term. So here n will get replaced with m because mth term. M minus 1 common difference is d. Correct? Now he says mth term is n. So that means this whole is equal to n. Okay. Now next data, nth term is equal to m. So again we'll substitute nth term. So a of n basically is equal to a plus n minus 1 d. So what is nth term here is m. So this equate to m. Okay. Now he is asking you that show that the rth term. How do you rth term? Rth term also can be written like this. A of r is equal to a plus r minus 1 into d. Okay. So this is what written now. So now we need to find the rth term in terms of this expression. We need to get m plus n m minus r. So we need to get the a value and the d value from these two equations and then substitute it here. Let's do how do we do that now. So this is the first equation out here and this is the second equation. So if we subtract this first and second, so what happens? A will get eliminated now. Let's try to do that. Huh? So how do you do that now? Let's try to eliminate this part. When you subtract 1 minus 2, 1 minus 2, what happens now? This becomes a m minus 1 d minus n minus 1 d is equal to n minus n. Okay. Now let's solve for the d now. What happens d now? So look at this. When you it becomes a dm minus d minus n d plus d is equal to m minus n. Sorry, n minus n. It becomes the n minus m. Fine. So look at this, minus d plus d get cancelled here. Now again we will take the d common here. So what it becomes here? D is equal to n minus n by this is m minus n. M minus n. So n minus m by m minus n. So basically it is nothing but you take the minus 1 common, it becomes minus n, it becomes a m minus n. So it cancels. So answer is minus 1. Okay. So d we got is minus 1. We'll substitute the d value in the first equation and we'll get the value of a now. So here what we'll do now, a plus, we'll substitute minus 1 is equal to n. Correct? Now a is equal to, what happens now? N minus, minus will go, minus will become plus here, plus n minus 1. So this is the, we get the a value and the d value here from here. Right? Now let's try to substitute in this equation where the rth term we need to find it now. A value we got is n plus m. N plus m minus 1 plus r minus 1 into minus 1. Right? Now let's try to open the bracket. N plus m minus 1, it becomes a minus r plus 1. Okay? So minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled. So it becomes a n plus m minus r. So this is the expression we wanted to find out. Right? So this is how simple it is, because whatever we have learned the general formula, we applied the same thing in this part to answer the questions. So I hope it makes some sense to you, because whatever the concept we have learnt it, I applied the same in solving the problems. There are more few problems you can attempt it. In case you have any doubts, you can always get back to me into the comment section and I will always I'll try my best to reply at the earliest. Okay. Please share this video to all your friends who have the similar kinds of doubts and they want to understand in the simple way. Okay. So let's make this country a better place to learn. All the best. Thank you so much.